Hey everybody, back here to give you an update on phase two of the boat build. I have some videos to the boat out on the water, but really a very slow video editor, so I'll instead provide a single take update on what I've been working on over the winter. And you can see here, so this is phase two, and the goal is just to be able to have two people sitting side by side and to be able to operate everything remotely. Before, we were using tiller steering, and that's just essentially it was tiller went right there. So this is a Mercury 15M with tiller, throttle, and steer, and I got some hardware to be able to remote all that. And for the steering, used a pretty standard Teleflex rotary steering rack, and you can see the part number here, and this is C-Star unit, pretty much the cheapest one out there. Then in order to attach that to the Mercury 15M motor, this is the steering link rod attaching kit that I got, and it's actually not quite right because this plate that comes with it is not made for this motor, and so I had to make this adapter plate that you see here. Went through a few iterations to kind of fine-tune everything, and this is the configuration that we ended up with here. And the positioning of this bolt is pretty critical. Any further out and you don't get enough travel, further in things tend to bind up. It also was kind of a pain to get it to be able to clear the motor. You see I ended up shaving a fair amount off, but works actually just the way it should. And get pretty much full travel to either side, and it's symmetrical, and should do what we need it to do. And you can see here's the steering rack in here. Now this will be covered, of course, with a top cover, but wanted to show you guys what it looks like before that. And the cable is routed up underneath the decking, punches through the decking. Covered this with a stainless steel vent cover. If you just look for a stainless steel boat vent cover, you'll find something like that. And then it goes here to the tilt tube on the motor. And this Mercury 15M tilt tube is actually a little bit short for this application. And when you go full travel in that direction, this arm pops out of the tilt tube and it binds up when you try to retract it. And so I made a 3D printed tilt tube extender that you can see here. Rather than just have the cap that comes with the control arm link kit sitting here and that's it, this actually is press fit onto that cap that screws on, and then extends it out an extra inch or so. And there's an O-ring in here that keeps everything clean. And so this is the part that it slips over, this part G, which is the cable seal that's part of this steering link rod attaching kit, which once again is not exactly the correct part number for this, but it's very difficult to identify correct part numbers for all of this. And I got close and worked with what I got. Now the remote control attaching kit is exactly correct, and this is what's needed for Mercury 15M in order to have your throttle and shifter be worked remotely by these cables coming off here, and then these go up to this pretty standard universal control box. You can find this on Amazon and eBay pretty easily. And These are C5 type cables that mount into this, and so this will sit, you know, somewhere around here. And then these cables, you know, are routed back, and everything then gets worked remotely. And it's working, this works exactly as it should. Also, you see a couple of cables, or a couple of wires coming out here, and that's for a kill switch to be mounted in the dash. Not that you really need it, because it's you're so close to the switch on the motor anyways, but it's kind of cool. So I'm going to add it on. And as you can see here, the you know, this dash piece, have an angled piece that runs across here. This is a 22.5 degree angle is what I ended up using. Tried out a few different configurations, and this is what seemed to be best. And actually removed this cross member that used to be in here. And you can see where it was patched a little bit, but it was able to match it up pretty well. And really just matched it by making an angled cut in to remove the trim to either side, and then cut a block to wedge in there at the same angle, and just trimmed it flush. So it wasn't too bad. And then, yeah, I really wanted to make sure that I preserved that structural integrity that cross member was providing. And so this dash should do that. And it actually, you know, conforms to the profile up underneath here, and is, you know, just epoxied in onto the inside hull and everywhere around it. And so I think, you know, this will perform essentially the same function. It is a little bit further forward, but I'm not too worried about it, especially because I was looking at some of the some other boat designs, especially the Glenel Squirt, and you know, this is well in line with what's used for other boats. I did notice, and you may have noticed too, there's some cracking in some of those blocks, and what I'm actually going to do is trim this down so it doesn't cut into your knees while you're sitting here, and remove these blocks and actually make an insert that slides across all of these stringers, and should be more rigid than those blocks, and hopefully provide the same total support as you know, this cross member was, without cutting into your legs. And then I'm gonna take out this decking, or take out the floorboards. I gotta extend it over, because you can see I just have this piece of plywood sitting in here to allow for enough support for these seats. These seats are probably just going to be temporary. I'd like to get something a little bit a little bit better looking, and you know, might get some custom upholstery done to do that. But yeah, this is essentially what phase two looks like, and I should have that done soon enough to get back out on the water for the spring. Something else I should note too is that I added these trim tabs on as well, because if you watch the maiden voyage video, you know, the boat really tended to do this as it was moving across, and also would oscillate, you know, do that porpoising. And adding these trim tabs on really helped with that. These are, I don't recall the exact manufacturer, but they're pretty easy to find, and they're these just hydraulic, you know, but passive trim tabs, and it does cut down on top speed just a little bit, but really makes for a much more stable ride overall. And then the other thing I'm going to do too is just probably make a cover for this front piece now that we're just going to have two people sitting side by side. It'll just, I think, provide for a cleaner look and also keep some of the water and spray out of the boat, because that is a little bit of an issue. And also then to hide the steering rack when it's viewed from this angle. And you can kind of see the steering rack from back here up underneath. And so I may make a cover for that, but we'll cross that bridge when we get to it, I think. And also in the meantime, I made a lot of shop upgrades, and that really has enabled this work to go a lot faster and easier. You know, it's really nice having everything in drawers, and I got this miter saw station here that really makes it easy to make precise cuts. And you know, you can see I can just, if you want to have a 40-inch long board, you know, you can just lock this down and set your piece up in the saw, and you're good to go. That's really been nice. And then also added in dust collection for all of the tools, and that's been really nice to have too. And you can see the dust collector in over here. And that's just the Harbor Freight cheapest dust collector, and some 4-inch drain PVC, scheduled 20 PVC running around, and a variety of adapters to do all that. And it has really made a difference. Makes it a lot easier to just do work instead of clean up after yourself after doing work. And the other thing I guess I should show you before I sign off. This is the control box that was used, that you see, you know, the throttle and shifter box is this UltraFlex control box. It's okay. It works. And like I said, I use the C5 type cables. Those fit on the Mercury motors, and really that portion of phase two went really smoothly because the throttle and steering adapter kit went on in an evening. The C5 cables don't need any sort of adapters or anything, and that's really straightforward to set up. So all the work has been really focused on the steering and getting all the adapters and everything set up for the control link arm to actually work. So that's everything that's going on with phase two. And go ahead and post this video, and I'll see you guys out on the water.